The one and only Michael Strahan joins us here on Radio Boss. He is Miles Truitt. He joins us here on Radio Boss. What's going on, Miles?
I need you to introduce me more, man. I love that, man. That was good. That was good.
Stephen A. Smith. He joins us once again here on BOXTOROW. He's an 8-time tag team champion. Main event! Jey Uso joining us here on the program.
Man, right on. It was appreciate the introduction, man.
Nia Jax, known as the Irresistible Force, 1-time Raw Women's Champion, 2-time WWE Women's Tag Team Champion, joining us here on the program. He's a grad of Mississippi Valley State, a former 3-time All-Pro in the National Football League with the New England Patriots, has had many stops in his coaching career. Welcome the new head football coach, North Carolina A&T, Vincent Brown, to the program. Right now, we have joining us who I think may be the best player in all of HBCU football. He is the quarterback for North Carolina Central. He is Davis Richard. Listen, when you can have a legendary figure on your show 2 times, you're doing something. We talked with her back in 2014. She's the one and only Dionne Warwick. Joins us here on BOXTOROW with the Radio Boss. In his first season as the general manager of the Detroit Lions, he is Brad Holmes. He joins us here on BOXTOROW. It's been a long time, Brad. Good to see you. Welcome to the program. Welcome to another edition of BOXTOROW's Countdown to 20. I'm your host, Donald Wares. We take a look and a listen back at some of our most memorable interviews over the almost 20 years that BOXTOROW has been on the air. And today we're going to take a listen back at the legendary, the one and only Sheryl Lee Ralph. You know, Sheryl Lee Ralph, the first time that I had a chance to see Sheryl Lee Ralph was back in 1989, a movie called The Mighty Quinn, also starring Denzel Washington. And she has had a phenomenal career. And I didn't know this until we had the interview about 3 years ago when I did some research about her acclaimed performance in the Broadway show Dreamgirls, which she was phenomenal in. A lot of you are going to know her from her role in Abbott Elementary, which she won an Emmy for, as a matter of fact. And she has had just a phenomenal career and a resurgence of sorts with her career in her role in Abbott Elementary. So once again, sit back, relax, and enjoy this listen back at the incomparable, the one and only Sheryl Lee Ralph, as BOXTOROW celebrates almost 20 years on the air. Let's continue here on From the Press Box to Press Run. I'll tell you what, we got royalty on the line. but I'm serious. So, you know, I gotta say this. So you talk about Dreamgirls. Well, let's talk with the original Dreamgirls member on Broadway. As a matter of fact, was nominated for a Tony Award. She's got a new project, Like, Comment, Subscribe, which airs Saturday on BET. She's Sheryl Lee Ralph, joins us here on the program. Sheryl, welcome to the program.
Thank you very much, Donald, and I love the inspiration. Yes, thank you.
Well, look, I'm saying when you got royalty on the line, you have to do it that way. Let me start here. So I know a lot of people, and it's interesting. I was reading an article that was in the Chicago Tribune, which I thought you were spot on in a lot of what you were saying. So there's like a resurgence in Moesha. By the way, we had Brandy on like a couple of months ago. And people, younger people more specifically, are starting to sort of either discover or rediscover you.
Oh, it's been amazing. The number of sites that have popped up on social media dedicated to me because these young people are watching Moesha or they're seeing Instant Mom. It is crazy, but I love it. And more than that, I love the way that they love me.
Yeah. You know, what's interesting, you mentioned Instant Mom, like my children watch the Nickelodeon and,
you know, all of the other kid shows that we didn't, stations we didn't have, you know, like growing up. So, you know, sort of speak to that and how, you know, you were at least enjoying Instant Mom and then some of the roles you were playing that were more kid friendly, if you will.
You know, it's so interesting. My whole career has been with on purpose and with intention. So for me to have been able to, and it's weird because I write about this specifically in my book, for me to be able to start out with the plan that says, I want whoever looks up at the screen and sees me, they're going to know, they're going to see something good. And if it shocks them, at least they're going to learn from it, that my intention is to always do good and raise the bar for them. Look at me and know if I can do it, you can do it. But it takes work and it's not always easy. So it's I'm happy that young people are discovering me now and saying, I love her. Yes, that's a good mother. I'm like, wow. They know what they're looking at and I so appreciate that.
Yeah, maybe that role opposed to your role on Moesha, where you, I mean, you're like in that role, in that character, like that character was strict, was all about those children, but doing the right things.
Absolutely. And it's crazy because the kids that were young back then, oh, they hated Dee. Oh, she's too strict. She's too much. She's too extra. All this. But now that they're grown and they're looking back on the show, they're like, oh my God, Miss Ralph, I love you. I'm still learning how to be a mother. I'm still learning how to be in this world watching you on TV. And I love that. As opposed to young people now watching the show and they're like, I love her. That's a good mother. I love her. This to me is quite a social experience.
Yeah. That voice of Sheryl Lee Ralph, who joins us here on BOXTOROW with the Radio Boss. Again, like, comment, subscribe, airs Saturday on BET. She directs this. So tell us more about like, comment, subscribe. How did it all come about?
You know, it's so interesting. BET Her created this initiative called The Waiting Room, where they wanted to bring attention to health matters in the Black community and community of color. And, you know, that's right in my wheelhouse. You know, I've spent these past 30 years trying to raise health awareness, and it all started around, you know, my concern for what the virus of AIDS could do to us as a community. You know, back then people told me I was crazy, I was stupid, don't do it. And I realized it was the right thing to do. So I was so happy to partner with BET Her as we were going to tackle mental illness and breast cancer. The mental illness pieces aired back in July. The breast cancer awareness pieces will air, like you're saying, on October 17th on BET Her. And when they gave this script to me, I was so pleased. I was so honored. But I was also shocked because the plot of the script was something that my family was going through personally. So it was crazy. It was crazy.
The one and only Sheryl Lee Ralph joins us here on the program. Can I take you back? Like, what do you remember, like, the Dream Girls on Broadway? So, there's a movie that, you know, came out in 06. But, I mean, you were part of that original cast on Broadway. By the way, nominated for a Tony Award. What did that mean to you? And what do you remember most about that time?
First of all, I remember the magic, the magic of having an audience stand up and roar with applause each and every night. It was an amazing gift. But more than that, through these years, I will always be somebody's dream girl, Tony-nominated actress. I will always be Moesha Mama. And most performers just pray, hope for one mark in, you know, entertainment history. And I have two very deep ones and I hold them very dearly. Almost as much as my book, you know, my book, Redefining Diva, throughout this quarantine, I was reading from the book and the audience demanded that I do an audio book. And I believe it or not, throughout quarantine, I was recording an audio version, an updated audio version of my book. and Audible heard about it. And now the book is available on Audible, Redefining Diva 2.0. So I've got three marks in entertainment history that I just hold dear, because there's nothing like people selling out on your book and buying your book. I'm like, thank you, people. Thank you.
I know that, Sheryl. I know it's not all about that, but get that money. No question about it. A couple of last thoughts. You know, in that piece in the Chicago Tribune, you talked about, and one of my favorite shows is Sanford and Son, and you talked about the experience you had with Bud Yorkin. Do you mind sharing that? And also, because we haven't seen a black woman win an Academy Award for Best Actress since Halle Berry. And of course, we've seen more recently supporting actress with Regina King. But can you share that story about Bud Yorkin and your thoughts on Hollywood?
It was so interesting because I was so young when that happened. And they did not hire me because they said I wasn't black enough. So you had a team of white producers, writer directors on this show, and they said that I was not black enough, meaning I did not fit into the caricature that they wanted to be seen. And I remember thinking to myself, he didn't say that I needed to change my hairstyle. He didn't say that I needed to lose some weight. He said that my complete being just was not good enough to play a black woman. And that always stuck with me because I thought to myself, wow, they're going to now write and tell us who we are. So I'm very, and I write about this in my book, how very happy I am to see more people of color represented now behind the camera, writing, directing, producing, creating. I'm very, very excited about that because what he said to me could have stopped me. It could have stopped me as a performer in my tracks, but I didn't let it stop me. So much so that years later, I mean like 20, 30 years later, I ran into him and he looked at me and said, I am sorry. I am sorry for what I said. I should never have said that. I had no understanding, and you are truly an outstanding actress performer.
Awesome.
So, you know?
Yes, yeah. Awesome. Like, comment, subscribe. Airs Saturday on BET, directed by the one and only Sheryl Lee Ralph, joins us here on the program. Sheryl, really appreciate the time. Continued success in all you do.
Thank you very much. I encourage everybody to watch, like, comment, and subscribe. Women, get into care, because everything changes if you are not there. And get to know your breasts. Do that monthly breast examination. October 17th, you can catch us on BET Her. Pick up my book, Redefining Diva 2.0. You are going to love what you hear, read by me, the author. And don't forget to vote. Vote like your life depends upon it. Because it does.
Well said. Thank you very much.
Thank you, and follow me.
Sure will.
Thanks.